Hey everybody, it's Morgan. Welcome back to another episode of Behind the Swirl. So today I'm here with James Himes. He's a safety coordinator at Indy Field Services in Indianapolis.
Today we're going to go through PPE from level D to level A.
All right, Caleb's going to be helping us a little bit today.
So thank you, Caleb.
Let's get started.
Let's get started.
So to first start out, this is our level D PPE. James, kind of what is included in this?
Okay, what we start out with in our PPE is a level D. And so level D includes steel-toed boots, pants, shirt, but these are FRC uniforms. Okay. So these are fire retardant uniforms. They'll slow down a flash fire or an arc fire at an electrical box. The next thing that a person in this level is going to have leather gloves. This is going to prevent cuts, punctures, if they're handling cable or something like that, and so drums, things like that. The next thing is eye protection, and so safety glasses are required all the time, and then a hard hat. Okay. So that's for any overhead hazard that might drop down, hit him in the head.
Okay. So the next thing is our level C PPE, so kind of what's included in this one?
Exactly. We still have the uniform under the level C suit, and we still have steel-toed boots, and on top of that, we have chemical booties.
Okay.
They have a wide range of chemicals so that if they get splashed on the boots and stuff like that. We tape the top of the boots so if there's any splash on the suit and it runs down, it'll eliminate that. This is a sealed seam suit, and what that means is they put a layer over the seam so that no vapors or liquids can get down in the sewn seam. This here is a full face respirator. It replaces the safety glasses and it protects our whole face. And so if we have an acid fume or something like that, you have to select the proper cartridges for that material.
Okay.
And then also this suit has a hoodie that comes up around, seals around the respirator, and takes care of any of that problem.
Perfect. And so then here, do they wear two different sets of gloves?
Absolutely. And so the orange glove is taped to the suit, and so that's really just for decon, so that he can take everything off and start deconning the suit and not get anything on his hands.
Perfect.
Then he'll take this glove off and he has another glove under it for deconning purposes too.
Perfect, so then they'll put this on over these whenever they go in.
Correct.
Perfect. Next level is our level B PPE, so kind of what's included in this?
Again, our suit is sealed seam and we still have work boots, steel toe boots underneath, chemical booties, and one of the big changes now is still have a full face respirator, but we also have supplied air.
Okay.
And so level B, you can either go a supplied air line to tanks or a generator that produces breathable grade D air.
Okay.
And or you can go SCBA.
Okay.
This here will supply him about 30 minutes of air.
Okay.
Now that'll depend on how hard he has to work, you know, how far he has to go, things like that. Because whatever time he spends going in, we got to have that time coming out too.
Right.
Because we'll have to decon it.
Okay.
Again, the same gloves with gloves underneath for deconning and things like that.
So this is our highest level of PPE, our level A PPE, correct?
That is correct. This suit again has sealed seams on it. Anywhere it's sewn, there is a layer of the same suit sealed to it so that no air can get in or out.
Okay.
This will not let the vapors come in, but it also won't let you be able to breathe in it. So it comes with a warning that you could suffocate in this suit if you wear it without a breathing apparatus.
So that's why it's important for us to kind of wear
the SCBA on the back. So if you turn it up sideways, again, this is the 30 minute pack, and it will last up to 30 minutes.
Okay.
The downfall in this suit is you've got to have time to decon.
Right.
So if you can go supplied airline, that's going to make this job a lot easier. Also with this suit, you're going to have your chemical boots on the, you've got to put them on first, and if we can pull this up, you can see the suit goes down inside the boot.
Perfect.
And then we have a flap that comes over it so that anything splashes doesn't go down inside the boot. You can keep all the contamination on the outside for deconning purposes.
Okay. So just an extra level of protection.
Absolutely.
Perfect.
All right, so with this level A suit, we have to connect the regulator before we bring the suit up and zip her up. Ready? You have to take a big deep breath. And now the SCBA is on, the regulator is working, and now we will zip up. All right, so once we get Morgan inside the level A suit, we zipped it up, and so then it's all Velcroed, and the weather stripping is sealed all the way to the top, so no vapors can get into the suit. It's totally sealed. Spin around here, Morgan. You have an exhalation valve back here that I can feel the air discharging, okay? The other thing you have with this suit is your gloves are sewn into the suit. It's got a banding. You can change those out. Any questions, Morgan?
No.
Not at all. One of the things you want to do, though, is make sure you do have a flexible range of motion before you get started. You see the suit starting to fill up with air from the SCBA.
Okay, so that's all we have for you guys today. Thank you for watching, and we will see you next time.
Thank you.
Thank you.